Alrighty, I'm back out at the 1715 permission. I've got a couple hours to detect. It's still springtime, so not everything has grown up yet. So I'm going to hit some areas I wasn't able to get into last fall. But I do have their display done. So when the owners get home today, I'll probably give this to them. So I finished putting it together today. Managed to get them a nice KG1 and KG2 and a 1817 coronet, as well as a couple of Indian heads, 1864 and 1903, buckles, pewter spoon, watch winder, you know, a lot of the different things you get when you detect a property like this. And then in case they forget, try to cover up the property address there, kind of put a legend there for them so they know exactly what it is and where it dates to. But hopefully they like it. I enjoy putting it together and see if I get to find anything else today. All right, wish me luck. All right, so I'm in this garden area here that was totally overgrown back in the fall. They haven't used it in several years. I got a couple pieces of scrap aluminum on my way in, and first brass target looks like foul stem cover. Maybe off a tractor. I am near the barn, so it makes sense. So, pretty cool. Hopefully I find some more interesting stuff. All right, got a really nice 1230 signal right here in the hole. Doesn't seem too big. It's usually maybe something lead, but I've gotten 3 cent pieces and even half dimes at that range. Here it is. And, okay, it's not bad. It's an umbrella slide or a parasol slide. There you go. All right, got a signal here by this wall built up near the barn and the animal shed here. It looks like it's very brittle, but looks like it's a lock plate or keyhole plate for a door. It's kind of cool. All right, this was a very low tone 9-3 signal here. It looks like a little mini garter belt suspender clasp or something like that. Not in the best of shape, but I'll take it. All right, I got a 1235 signal, and it was really shallow. Thought it might just be canslaw, but it looks like it's a little bracelet. Looks like it might have something inscribed in its the front of it, but I can't make it out right now. Oh, look at that. That broke. There's probably more in there somewhere. This brass probably silver plated at one point. Alrighty, missed that the first time I went through here. Alright, got a little suspender clasp here, nothing fancy. Totally utilitarian, I think. Found several others like this around here. This one's probably in the best shape I've seen it in. There we go. On to the next. Next item up is a lantern top. Wonder if I can get a patent date on this. All right. Patent is 1868. Pretty cool. All right, so I'm down about 9 or so inches. And it's got probably one of the biggest keyhole covers I've ever found in my life. I think it's huge. My goodness. Can you imagine the key that went in there? It's just immense. All right, well, I was going along, heading to my car, and caught something out of the corner of my eye, and I wonder if you could see it yet. Ooh, look at that tongue go. Really startled me. Let's see how close I can get. He's not happy with me, but... garter snake. It's kind of cool. It certainly does startle you when it goes tearing away as you're walking by, though. Yeah. All right, I'll let him be. I got a 1230 signal here. It looks like I got a brass wedding band. Probably has some decent age to it. There you go. Alrighty, on to the next. Alright, so I got a 1245 signal in the hull here. I don't know if you can see it. It's right here. I see the edge of something. I think it might be a coin. I'm hoping it's a coin. It's kind of shadowed in there right now, but do it live here. Oh yeah, that's a copper. Yeah, I could see Lady Britannia on this side. Right face embossed. Nothing on the side here, so this is King George the First. This is probably like the fourth or fifth one I found on this site. I was just about to give up on this area, I hadn't been finding anything. I don't know if I'm going to get a date out of this or not. All right, so I just got a signal here. I was reading around 1537 up at the surface, and cut the plug and I flipped the soil and I see a little bit of green here, so I haven't looked at it yet, but hoping it's a Indian head given the reading it had. Yep. Looks like it's a 1901 Indian head. Sweet. The day's picking up. All right, I've got a few brass items, a horse tack, harness buckle, and a few other odds and ends. Finally got a pretty interesting signal here. It looks like a really small baby-sized pewter spoon. It's crumbling apart right now. It's got that rat tail on it. You know it's got some age to it. can't even see the screen of my camera. It's so bright out right now. Pretty cool. All right, I got like 15 more minutes and I gotta take off. I'll let you know if I find anything else. All right, so I got a really faint signal. I'm up closer to this bush than I probably would have been able to last year. And I see something that sort of make me happy. Hopefully you guys can see this. I see something that looks really nice. I think this is a silver dime. Hold on just a minute. Okay, thank you Hoover Boys for the idea. I see 1 cent. Awesome. Sorry, 1 dime. I'm a little excited. I don't even know what I'm saying anymore. There we go. Let's flip it over. I see Lady Liberty sitting down. Very worn. Oops, where'd it go? See the dime here. Is the date. Looks like 1877. Sweet. 1877. I forgot to check to see if there's a mint mark. Oh. Oh my goodness. 1877. Carson City? I've never found a CC back mark. Anytime. Oh my goodness, I'm so excited. Oh, that is so cool. Oh, awesome. Was not expecting this. Oh, sweet. Very happy. And I gotta get going, so this will be my last signal of the day. All right.